To learn more about picking locks from Houdini's era, Lee is visiting locksmith and Houdini expert Steve Sharp.
So it feels like I'm giving this a little bit of a turn as well as
pulling on
as the pull.
Right. Now you gotta remember this is a little over 100 years old, yeah. So the spring, it's not gonna jump that shackle up real fast.
Okay, so just a little bit of tension.
And then you just rake it and then turn it until it. There it is.
There it goes.
Good job.
That's a relief. I wonder if Houdini felt this way after picking a big, fat Russian prison lock.
Is there maybe a pick set that I could take with me to practice?
I can set you up with a lot of old locks. I got buckets of that.
You got some old locks and some picks?
I really do. I really do.
Looks like I got some homework to do.
Yeah, you do.
Thank you again.
Oh, my pleasure.
All right.
Handling the same locks Houdini used in his escapes makes me appreciate his skills on a whole new level.
There are so many stories of his amazing lock-picking skills, and the Russian escape isn't even the only one that points to him being a spy.
Houdini may have used a false thumb for more than the thumb racket. It may be the secret behind his most famous jailbreak ever, Scotland Yard. The year was 1900. Houdini lands in England, and he's such a nobody he can't get booked. A theater owner says, "Escape from Scotland Yard and I'll book you." Scotland Yard at the time was the most secure facility in Britain. While there, he's locked to a pole in the holding cells. And moments later, escapes from his cuffs. He's instantly famous in England. After his escape, Houdini becomes close friends with William Melville, the head of Scotland Yard, who eventually becomes the first chief of British military intelligence. So Houdini could have been auditioning to be a British spy 3 years before he went to Russia.
All right, Lee, you ready for this?
I'm ready. You have the cuffs?
You got the wrists?
I got the wrists.
Here we go.
Before Lee can try any of his tools, he's got to escape from the handcuffs. And then the Carette.
Here we go.
Lee's got the same tools that Houdini would have engineered for this escape. We've given Lee an escape plan and a backup. Now it's up to him. We've secured Lee with a lock the same as what they would have used in 1903.
You're locked in. Good luck, comrade.
When Houdini did the Carette escape, he had the Carette backed up to a wall so no one could see what he was doing. This curtain is our wall.
According to Houdini's lithograph, he escaped the Carette in 28 minutes. We're giving Lee the same amount of time. Is Lee going to attempt to saw his way out or pick both the handcuffs and the Carette lock?
My first move is to retrieve the saw from my fake thumb. Then retrieve the extender from my false heel.
Every magician knows there is no such thing as having too many backups. The locksmith gave me an idea and one more theory I want to try out.
Houdini made picks that were concealable in the cheek.
That's interesting.
Handcuffs, no problem. My initial problem is that I can't see the lock. When I practiced picking locks at Steve Sharp's place, I was able to see the locks. In the Carette, I'm blind. I can't get the leverage I need to pick the lock, and time is ticking away. Because I can't physically see the lock, and I can't identify it by touch, and I couldn't open it with the small lock pick, I must have chosen the wrong picks to bring with me for the lock on the correct door. And with my backup plan being the extension pick, I'm pretty sure that's not gonna work either, because the pick part is so similar to the first pick I tried. So I'm going with the backup of the backup plan, the saw.
Dude, I'm gonna be here forever.
14 minutes, halfway.
Houdini talked about being drenched in sweat when he emerged from the Carette. I'm beginning to understand why.
Ah!
I can hear him. If Houdini did use a saw, I would think the prison guards would have jailed him for real, for ruining the Carette.
I don't see him breaking through.
This is not happening.
23 minutes.
Houdini claims that he made the Carette escape in 28 minutes. I'm at 23 minutes. I'm almost out of time. The saw might work if I had all night. Prisoners would spend weeks in these things. They would have plenty of time to saw through the zinc floor. The only thing I can do at this point is to switch back to the picks. I have no choice but to now try the extension pick.
I believe Houdini escaped the Carette in 1903, but I'm not sure Lee will do it today.
Lee's been in there a long time. We're coming up on 27 minutes.
You did great.
Easy?
It was a challenge, for sure.
This was a very difficult escape. I really questioned whether I had planned this out as well as Houdini would have, especially after I failed to pick the Carette lock with the small lock pick. It was just too hard to manipulate the lock with it. That's when I assumed that my extension pick would also fail, so I switched to the saw. That was a big mistake, because I burned through almost all of my time. My only chance for escape had to be the extension lockpick. Using the extender, I could work the lock with both hands and manipulate the pick pretty aggressively from multiple angles. This was very effective, and hearing that click was the best sound of my life.
The extension tool was pretty crucial for me.
Okay, so he probably would have had that.
He definitely would have.
You did a great job.